The following is an article published in the journal At Tarde in the column Opinion on November 6, 2014 by Divaldo Pereira Franco, entitled Empty Lives. According to Dr. Elisabeth Lukas, a noble disciple of the Austrian psychiatrist Viktor Frankl, today's society has lost its traditions, abandoned myths, and disorganized the family, leading to the suffering of the painful psychological circumstances of existential emptiness. Its victims walk with no greater aspirations because they are fixated on the primary instincts, eating, sleeping, and having sex, than in the sentiments that elevate and promote the human being to the heights of self-illumination and plenitude. She suggests reflections of her experience in logotherapy, very valuable to the acquisition of inner peace in these turbulent days of the human existence. She proposes, par excellence, you will maintain your relation with transcendence, you will conserve your receptivity to values, you will collect yourself periodically in order to speak with your conscience, and concludes, you will not aspire to have, but to be. In an excellent synthesis, we are invited to analyses surrounding our transcendence, of the exuberant life, of the immortality in which we find ourselves immersed, even though in the carnal investiture, while suggesting the existential psychological sense, the discovery of the values that ennoble, proposing the dialogue with the conscience, in order to overcome the negative inclinations and to impede the installation of guilt, whose effects are pernicious to emotional stability. Finally, in an age of consumerism and voluptuous individualism, it proposes the to be instead of to have, which disharmonizes all of those who give into it in character and devotedness. It is necessary that the human being fills his existential emptiness, returning to the spiritual origins whence it came, and, at the same time, be able to establish rules of healthy conduct in relation to all of the various expressions of life. No one is able to live peacefully and with health if they do not possess significant ethics, or does not fulfill tasks that give value to their existence. In order to reach such a result, the well-being, it is necessary to love without worrying about being loved.